I'm going to show you guys how to edit slow motion footage on your iPhone 6. The iPhone 5 does this too. The iPhone 6 is just amazing at how slow you can get your slow motion to work. But invariably, just you can't get the timing right when you're shooting slow motion, so you have to do a really quick edit, and you can do that right inside your iPhone before posting your video. So I'm just going to take a video that I shot this past weekend. Here's a 34-second long video, and what's important here is to look across the top so you see the entire timeline of the video, and then right below that you see the little blue bars, and the blue bars are representing the speed of the video. So if you just touch that and move it around, you can see bars close together means that it's running at full speed, and bars far apart means that it's running in slow motion. So by default, what Apple's done is they made the beginning and the end of your slow motion videos run at full speed, and then it kind of switches over, which is kind of cool. But if that's not the effect you're looking for and you want to have the whole thing slow motion, just tap on your screen, get to that spot, and drag those out. So I want my slow video to go slow motion the entire time. There it is. So it's across the whole thing going slow motion. The next thing I want with this is, you know, Ed was really messing with the dogs here for a while, and so we ended up recording about 32 seconds of him trying to get the dog's attention. So I'm going to cut off the beginning of this video just by clicking on the little black arrow, and then it turns to yellow, and then you slide it across to the point that you want to start the video. So I'm going to back up here right before Ed throws the ball. You can trim off the far side too. But then you just hit the trim command, and then I always do save as a new clip, just in case you make a mistake, you want to be able to go back to the original. And you can see now this is the video in slow motion, but just the last tiny little bit. Now my dog is the golden retriever, and as you can see, she's not going to be the one who catches that ball. So kudos to Ed's dog, and kudos to you guys. Be sure to trim down those videos, get them to be the exact length that you want before you post them up to Facebook or YouTube. But just really pretty simple to do that. There you go. And I hope you guys will join me again, post videos like this once a week at least.